What's up, guys? It's Turtle from Carolina Vapor Mill in Greenville. I'm doing a little comparison today because I get a lot of people in the shop that ask me which one I like better. So we are talking about the Kanger Subtank. Wow, I'm already breaking things. Kanger Subtank and the Aspire Atlantis. So just so you know, for the sake of comparison, I have the same 70-30 liquid in both of these. It's called Hair of the Dog. You can come by and check it out whenever you'd like. The same liquid. They both have brand new coils in them. I just put brand new coils in both of them. They've both been primed the same way. Just 5 drops down in the coil and let the soak for about 30 seconds. And I'm going to be using them both first on the Aspire sub-ohm battery. This is fully charged. And just to be consistent, so there's no adjustment or anything with this, it's just what the battery outputs, which, yeah, it's 4.2 volts at 40 amps, or that's what it's capable of, is 40 amps. So, first of all, since it's made for it, let's go ahead and screw on the Atlantis. I do have the airflow wide open on both of these, so we'll run it wide open. And give it a shot. I've been using the Atlantis for a while. I've been using the Subtank for a while. I kind of switch back and forth depending on which flavor I'm using. So I tell everybody that comes in the store, I'm a big fan of both of them, and I really am. They both have their purpose. I feel like they both have unique qualities about them that the other one doesn't. And I feel like, I almost feel like you get better flavor out of the Atlantis, but I'm on the fence about that. I'm not sure. excuse me. Now, even though it's a little big on it, let's take a look at the Kanger Subtank. Same battery, same setup, not adjustable. It's funny, this is the first time that I've back-to-back hit the Atlantis and the Subtank with the same liquid in it at the same time. On the same device, the Subtank's a little quieter, I feel like. The airflow, when you're pulling through it, and I pull pretty hard through a tank, it's a little quieter. I don't feel like I have to take as long of a drag on the Subtank as I do on the Atlantis. So that tells me it's creating a little more vapor. Just to give you kind of a breakdown of what is what in each of these, the Atlantis does still come with the ceramic type coil. It's a center tube down the middle of it. That's the coil, is the center tube. That's where the airflow passes through. That is wrapped in a ceramic wicking material, which is then wrapped in cotton around the outside, or a cotton-like material. And that's your filler in between the ceramic and the outside of the coil. The Kanger Subtank is very similar to what you would find in a K-Fun or something like that. The coil head is designed a little different than a K-Fun, but you have basically a coil where none of the leads are touching each other, with cotton through the center, making the Subtank coils, in fact, very easy to re-wick. I basically just run it dry and charred the cotton out of it, and then pulled a new piece through, pushed it against the side, and I've got basically a brand new coil. And I've done that 4 or 5 times with some of these coil heads. Obviously, the size is a big difference. The Subtank, you're holding about 7.5 mil. The Aspire Atlantis, you're holding about 1.5 mil, which, again, I feel like both of them have their place. If you're an all day, you know, you're in a truck all day or something, you don't want to be refilling a lot, This guy's going to be great for you. If you are one that likes to switch through flavors a lot, the Atlantis is going to be good for you. As far as flavors concerned, I don't really feel like I got better flavor or worse flavor off of either of them. Maybe a little more on the sub tank, but not worth writing home about. It's good. I don't know that it's that much better. So now we're going to take the sub-ohm battery off, and let's put them on a 120 Raptor box. This is the 75 box. And we'll turn it not all the way up, but where I usually like to run them is all the way up and a quarter of the way back down. I will leave it there. You can see probably where the pot is set on the inside there with the arrow pointing towards my finger here. Sub tank is just fine. It's very similar. I feel like I'm right around the same voltage as the sub battery. So let's go up just a little bit from there. Now I'm about, I'd say 11 o'clock on that potentiometer. So I would assume right around 5 volts. I haven't measured it, but that's about what it feels like. This is where you start to get some burnt hits with the sub on, the sub tank rather. Is right around 5 volts, even pulling hard through it. Now, I have run it about that same level and closed the airflow off. One, sometimes two, depending on how hard I'm pulling that day. And it's fine. But you do start getting burnt hits around almost all the way up, around 5 volts. Let's fire the Atlantis around 9 o'clock, so pointed off to the left, maybe around 4.2 volts. Again, just fine. We'll go to 11 o'clock, where we started to get burnt hits with that one. Can chain vaping this pretty heavily, no burnt hits. So same level, same voltage output, no burnt hits. Flavor was a little diminished when I got up there, but it's not burning. It's still hitting good. Was creating more vapor. So I feel like the wicking material in the Atlantis is the subject of a lot of argument right now, and I'm fine with all that. Whether you like it or you don't like it, it does hold up a little better. I feel like maybe that's a product of the way the coil's built, who knows. But it does hold up a little better at a higher voltage than the sub tank. The only difference, the benefit of the sub tank in this scenario, is the 1.2 ohm coil. The Atlantis only comes with a 0.5 ohm coil. The sub tank comes with two coils. It comes with a 0.5 and a 1.2. The 1.2 ohm coil, I religiously run at 6 volts all day long. 6 volts at 1.2 ohms, I don't know the math off the top of my head, but I assume it's about 30 watts, something like that. It runs fantastic. I turn it up, I get fantastic battery life out of my 120 Raptor 75 box, and it doesn't burn. It's perfect to me. So that's one thing about the sub tank that I will say is better. I like that it comes with that option. So, you know, with the 1.2 ohm coil, you can fire it on, it's on a 30 watt device. It's perfect. To me, the Atlantis with the 0.5 coil, if I put it on a 30 watt device, is not quite enough for me. I need about 40 to 42 watts. It's my sweet spot with the Atlantis. So that is one benefit of the sub tank over the Atlantis. So if you'd like to see these, if you'd like to try them out, or if you have any other questions about the Kanger Subtank or the Aspire Atlantis, feel free to come by our store in Greenville or Spartanburg, either one, and we'll hook you up. We're also selling, right now, the Atlantis is selling on BoilerEsigs.com. So if you'd like to pick one up, swing by there and pick one up. Thanks for watching. Have a good day.